ओम शांति। मॉर्निंग मुरली, 11th मई। स्वीट लेटर ऑफ बाप दादा फॉर स्वीट स्वीट चिल्ड्रन। एसेंस, स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, इट इज़ ओनली यू हु हैव बीन सेपरेटेड फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड बीन प्लेइंग योर पार्ट्स ऑफ द फुल 84 बर्थ्स। स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, इट इज़ ओनली यू हु हैव बीन सेपरेटेड फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम and been playing your parts of the full 84 births. You now have to go from the bondage of sorrow into relationships of happiness. Therefore, stay in limitless happiness. Therefore, stay in limitless happiness. Question: which children can have constant limitless happiness? Which children can have constant limitless happiness? Answer: those who have the faith. What faith? First, Baba has come to make us into the masters of the world. Second, our true Baba has come to give us the true knowledge of that same Gita. Third, we souls are now sitting in God's lap. We souls now belong to the Father through our bodies. We souls are now sitting in God's lap. We souls now belong to the Father through our bodies. Baba has come to give us salvation, the fruit of our devotion. Fifth, Baba has made us viewers of the three aspects of time, Trikaldarshi. Sixth, God has become our mother and adopted us. So we are godly students. Those who have this awareness and faith experience limitless happiness. Om Shanti. You children have the faith that you are souls. Baba, God is teaching us. Therefore, you children should have a lot of happiness. By personally coming in front of Baba, you souls understand that Baba has come to grant salvation to everyone. He is the bestower of salvation for all and the bestower of liberation in life. You children know that Maya repeatedly makes you forget Him. Maya repeatedly makes you forget Him. However, you understand that you are sitting in front of Baba. Incorporeal Baba is sitting in this chariot. Muslims put a sash around a horse and they say that Muhammad used to ride that horse. They use that symbol. Here, incorporeal Baba has incarnated in this one. You children should experience a lot of happiness. You children should experience a lot of happiness. Baba, who makes you into the masters of heaven and the world, has come. Baba is the true God of the Gita. The intellects of soul go to the Father. This is the love of souls for the Father. Which children experience this happiness? Those who have been separated for a long time. Baba Himself says, I sent you into relationships of happiness and you are now in bondage of sorrow. You now understand that not everyone takes 84 births. A cycle of 8.4 million births could not sit in anyone's intellect. Baba has explained the cycle of 84 births to you very accurately. Children of Baba, continue to take 84 births. You now know that your souls are listening through your organs. Baba is speaking to us through this mouth. He Himself says, I have to take the sport of these organs. He has to be named Brahma. He has to be named Brahma. प्रजापिता ब्रह्मा हैज टू बी अ ह्यूमन बीइंग. यू कैन नॉट से दैट प्रजापिता ब्रह्मा फादर ऑफ पीपल एग्जिस्ट इन द सबटल रीजन. गॉड कम्स इन टू द कॉर्पोरियल वर्ल्ड एंड सेज आई एंटर द बॉडी ऑफ ब्रह्मा एंड अडॉप्ट यू. यू नो दैट यू सोल्स आर अडॉप्टेड बाय गॉड. यू कैन नॉट बी अडॉप्टेड विदाउट अ बॉडी. You cannot be adopted without a body. The soul says, I belong to you through this body. That one has taken this body on loan. This body does not belong to him. The soul has entered the body. So you souls to have entered bodies. Baba says, I have entered this one. Sometimes I become the child and sometimes I become the mother. He is the magician. Some consider these things to be magic. There is a lot of false occult power in the world. They even become Krishna. Those who have faith in Krishna will quickly be able to see Krishna and will also believe in him and become his followers. Here everything is a question of knowledge. So first of all, each of you has to have the firm faith that you are a soul. Baba says, I am your father. I make you children, Trikaldarshi, viewers of the three aspects of time. No one else can give such knowledge. The father has to come when it is the end of the path of devotion. Many people have visions of a Shiva Lingam or a constant eternal form of light. I fulfill whatever faith and devotion someone has. However, none of them can meet me. They don't recognize me at all. You now understand that Baba is a point and that we are also points. I, this soul, have this knowledge within me. You souls also have this knowledge within you. No one knows that I, the soul, reside in the supreme abode. When you come and sit in front of Baba, you have goose pimples of happiness. Oho, Shiv Baba, who is the ocean of knowledge, is sitting in this one and is teaching us. There is no question of Krishna or gopis. They neither exist here nor in the golden age. There, every prince would live in his own palace. Only those who come and claim their inheritance from the father will understand these things. So you should have this happiness in you. They say you are the mother and father, but they don't understand the meaning of that. He is the father, so then who is the mother? The mother is definitely needed. That mother cannot have a mother. This secret has to be understood very clearly. You also have to remember the father. The father says you should not have any defects. They sing, I am virtuous and I have no virtues. You children now have to become virtuous. You must not have any lust, anger or arrogance of the body. You are now sitting here. You know that you are here and so why should you wilt? However, only at the end will your stage become firm. It has been remembered, if you want to know about super senses joy, ask the gopis and gopis. This will be at the end. None can say that they can stay in super senses joy 75% of the time. None can say that they stay in super senses joy 75% of the time. At this time, there is a hug burden of sin. Sins cannot be cut away by the blessing of a Guruji or by bathing in Gangas. It is only at the end that the Father comes and give you this knowledge. They have shown Akumari shot arrows and that he died. Means Bhisham Pitama. He was given the water of the Gangas to drink when he was dying. So when you become unconscious here, you are reminded of Baba. Constantly remember me alone. Constantly remember me alone. You children should instill this habit. You should not have to rely on someone to remind you. At the time of leaving your body, you should automatically remember. You have to remember the Father without help from anyone. Those people give mantras, but that is a common thing. At that time, there will be a lot of fighting and violence, etc. You stay at different places. At that time, you would not be able to told to say Shiva, Shiva. At that time, you will have to be in complete remembrance and also have love for him. Only then can you claim a number one status. You children know that I am your father. I am your father. I even made you children into beautiful flowers in the previous cycle. In the golden age, children will be like flowers and born through the power of yoga. Nothing that causes sorrow will exist there. Nothing that causes sorrow will exist there. The very name is heaven. However, the people of Bharat don't know who reside there. However, the people of Bharat don't know who reside there. They have written many stories in the scriptures such as Hiranyakashyap existed there, etc. All of that is the paraphernalia of devotion. Devotion is at first Satopradhan, then later it gradually becomes Tamopradhan. The Father says, I take you up to the sky and later you gradually come down. There is no praise of human beings. Only the one Father is the bestower of salvation for all. Those gurus teach you how to go on many types of pilgrimage, etc. In spite of that, you continue to fall. Although Meera had visions on the path of devotion, she did not become a master of the word. She did not become a master of the word. Baba tells you to become Jainis. I give you something to do. Simply continue to remember Alf and B. If you become tired and don't remember me, Maya will eat you raw. There is also a story of the jinn eating someone raw. Baba says, if you don't remember me, Maya will eat you raw. When you sit in remembrance, you experience happiness. Baba is making us into the masters of the word. Baba is sitting in front of you. You souls are listening to him. Sweet beloved children, I have come to take you to the land of liberation. Although many people try to go back home, no one is able to do so. The golden age has to come after the iron age. Day has to follow night. So you know that only we will exist in the golden age. Baba is once again giving us our fortune of kingdom. The mercury of happiness will rise at the end. Destruction will take place in the final moments. You will continue to see everything as detached observer. There will be unnecessary bloodshed. What crime have people committed that bombs etc. have been manufactured to kill everyone? Baba is saying everyone will of course die. They believe that someone is inspiring them to make those bombs etc. against their conscious wish. There is a lot of expense. It is fixed in the drama that destruction has to take place through them. One religion cannot rule amongst many other religions. The innumerable religions are now to be destroyed and the one religion established. You know that we are establishing the kingdom by following Baba's Shrimat. Those people go away to learn drill on a field. They believe that they have to kill or be killed. It is not like that here. So you should have a lot of happiness that Baba has come. It was incorporeal God who taught the ancient Raj Yoga of Bharat. They changed the name and mentioned the name of Krishna. Sannyasis believe their yoga is the ancient yoga. Everything is explained to you so clearly. Children, do you recognize me? I am your father. I alone am called the purifier and the ocean of knowledge. Krishna cannot come into the impure world. They have portrayed Krishna in the copper age. That is such a great mistake. They have become completely tamo pradhan. I come when everyone has to be taken to the land of liberation. You know that you are studying. We are godly students. So continue to churn this and you will have goose pimples of happiness. So why do you forget them? Baba is making you children understand concepts of knowledge. Why do you forget them? As soon as a child is born, he begins to say, Baba, you understand that you are here. Therefore, constantly remember the grandfather. Baba is giving the direction. Children, lust is a great enemy. It has caused you a lot of sorrow from its beginning through the middle to end. This is the land of death, the brothel. Rama is creating Shivalaya, the temple in which there is the kingdom of deities. However, how and when did they claim their kingdom? You know this? Those people think that gods and goddesses never take rebirth. If one important person were to be understand these things, the sound would spread. No one listens to the poor. Among you too, there are those who imbibe this number wise. There is just the one school and the one teacher, but the student are all number wise. Acha, to the sweetest beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children and we spiritual children says namaste, good morning to our sweetest spiritual father. Essence for dharana, first, in order to be protected from any attacks of maya, become a jinn and continue to remember Alf and B. Remove the burden of sin on your head with the power of yoga. Stay in super senses joy. Second, don't just chant the name of Shiva with your mouth. Have true love for the father. Have true love for the father. Remain busy in doing the service of changing thorns into flowers. Today's blessing. Feel Baba's hand on your head and take blessing. May you make accurate judgments with your carefree stage and become a victorious jewel with faith in your intellect. May you make accurate judgments with your carefree stage and become a victorious jewel with faith in your intellect. The easy way to become constantly victorious is to have one strength and one sport. When you have faith in one, you receive power. Faith constantly makes you carefree, and those who have a carefree stage are successful in every task they perform. Faith constantly makes you carefree, and those who have a carefree stage are successful in every task they perform. By being carefree, your intellect is able to make accurate judgments. So the basis of making accurate decision is to have an intellect with faith and being carefree. You don't even have to think, because you just have to follow the Father. Place your steps in His steps and move along according to the Shrimat you receive. Place your steps in His steps and move along according to the Shrimat you receive. Simply continue to place your steps in the steps of Shrimat and you will become a victorious jewel. Slogan: for your mind to have benevolent feelings for everyone. For your mind to have benevolent feelings for everyone is to be a world benefactor. Is to be a world benefactor. Om Shanti. Invaluable elevated versions by Mateshwari Ji. Will we receive the godly knowledge that we are receiving now at the confluence age in the golden age too? Will we receive it? No. For this, it is explained that in the golden age, we ourselves will be embodiments of knowledge. We will be experiencing our deity reward. There is no exchange of knowledge there. It is those who have no knowledge who need knowledge. It is those who have no knowledge who need knowledge. In the golden age, all are embodiments of knowledge. There is no one ignorant there that there would be a need to give them knowledge. At this time, we know the beginning, middle, and end of the whole unlimited drama. Who were we in the beginning? Where did we come from? How did we become trapped in the bondage of karma in the middle? And then how did we fall? At the end, we have to go beyond the bondage of karma and become karmatit deities. With the effort we are making now, we will have the future reward, that is of being golden aged deities. If we had the knowledge there that we deities would fall, our happiness would disappear with that thoughts. So we don't have the knowledge of our falling there. We don't have these thoughts there. Through this knowledge, we now know that we have to ascend and create our lives of happiness. We will experience our reward for half the cycle, then forget ourselves, be influenced by Maya and fall. We will experience our reward for half the cycle, then forget ourselves, be influenced by Maya and fall. This ascending and descending is an eternally predestined play. We have all of this knowledge in our intellects at this time. It does not exist in the golden age. It does not exist in the golden age. अच्छा, ओम शांति, थैंक यू बाबा.